Lovely day. If everybody would stand, we're going to say the Pledge of Allegiance this morning. We pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I didn't have any announcements, I'm sorry. Did anybody need to have anything to share? You're up.
In terms of page 486 and page 4, we give them all the verses.
God of our Father. singing.
It's time for our responsive reading, 605. Rejoice in the Lord always. I will say it again, rejoice. Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your requests to God, and the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus.
Finally, brothers, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy,
think about such things.
Whatever you have learned or received or heard from me or seen in me, put it into practice, and the God of peace will be with you.
I can do everything through him who gives me strength.
Amen.
Now it's time for our prayer focus. There are some names on the back of the bulletin to please keep in prayer. Does anybody have any prayer requests or praises? Well, I actually have, it's a combination of both. I have a very dear friend of mine, she's 55, and she had a heart attack on Tuesday. And the miracles that went into her still being here today are too many to tell you about. But the one I will share is that she had her heart attack in a cardiologist's office. So they worked on her for 45 minutes to bring her back. And she is home and feeling good. So that's a praise and also a prayer request.
Yes, it is.
That is good.
Amen.
Praise Olivia's morning sickness. His level, at least. She said, still feels a little off, but she's able to get up, get around, eat. She can eat, you know, and you know, our Olivia's kind of like playing like a teacup size, you know, so she needs to eat. She definitely needs to eat. So she turned the corner like Tuesday, I believe it was. But she had a bad weekend last weekend.
Good. I'm glad she's feeling better.
Thank you.
Anyone else?
Have we heard about Dottie's granddaughter? I didn't hear about that.
I have not.
Anyone? Okay. Want to reach out.
Anyone else? All right.
Bow together in prayer, shall we? Our Father, this is the day the Lord hath made, and we will be glad and certainly rejoice in it. We thank you for the opportunity to be together and to worship. May our worship be acceptable in your sight. Just so grateful for everyone that has come out to be in our service today. We give you praise for answered prayer. Thank you that you do hear us when we pray. We especially are grateful for the good report Kathy shared regarding her friend. And we do pray that you will continue to minister to her as she recuperates. We bring to you Olivia. We pray that you will be with her, especially during these times whereby she needs supernatural help and strength physically. All of the other needs that have been presented, we each carry personal problems and unspoken requests that only you know about, and we bring them to you. Bless in our service, especially as we look into your word. Teach us to pray as you taught your disciples, saying together, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power.
come to another important time of our service, and as I was reflecting this morning about how God has continued to be with us and personally has continued to amaze me with his presence and his encouragement in my own personal life. I know I waver. I'm at the age now where I waver between despair and depression and joy.
Oh.
And joy in there too. But it is so easy to look around, read the newspapers, watch the TV. It's so easy to come away from that and say, wow, is there any hope? But then when you go to prayer, and when you take a few moments to reflect on the Lord, he's always there and is always encouraging. And I am so grateful for that. And reminded regularly as well that I need to express my gratitude more often. A gracious people are a happy, joyful, dynamic, growing people. And I pray that this morning as we give, we will keep that in mind and recognize that this is an opportunity for us in just some small way to show our God how much we appreciate and love him. So thinking about all these things, may God bless you, bless all of us as we bring to him our tithes and our offerings this morning. Bob, please wait upon us. Thank you.
Thank you.
may be seated.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I'm going to read Joshua 4, 1 to 7. When the whole nation had finished crossing the Jordan, the Lord said to Joshua, "Choose 12 men from among the people, one from each tribe, and tell them to take up 12 stones from the middle of the Jordan, from right where the priests were standing, and carry them over with you, and put them down at the place where you stay tonight." So Joshua called together the 12 men he had appointed from the Israelites, one from each tribe, and said to them, "Go over before the ark of the Lord, your God, in the middle of the Jordan. Each of you is to take up a stone on his shoulder, according to the number of the tribes of the Israelites, to serve as a sign among you. In the future, when your children ask you, 'What do these stones mean?' tell them that the flow of the Jordan was cut off before the Ark of the Covenant of the Lord. When it crossed the Jordan, the waters of the Jordan were cut off. These stones are to be a memorial to the people of Israel forever."
Amen. Thank you so much. I would like to say a great big thank you for all of those that participated in our service today. They were either veterans or they had association with the veterans, military, and their families. So we say thank you to all of you that participated in church. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Amen.
Also, in your bulletin, and it will appear in several bulletins, you will note that there is a phone number that I have provided for you and for you to give to anyone that feels necessary that they should have. And I'll simply read the announcement. Should anyone be in need of pastoral care, counseling, what have you, just utilize and place the call. And the cell phone number is there at the bottom. Write it down and make it available to you. Also, on the back of the bulletin, and this will begin next week, I will be in the office available beginning Thursday, June 3rd from 9:30 a.m. to 1:30 p.m. And again, the same announcement. Feel free to call the office should you care to speak with me or make an appointment during those hours. And it's most important that people know that in times of need, we can pray together and agree in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
And He is the great physician and the one that hears our prayers. When my wife and I are traveling to come to you, we pass several churches. I like to read church signs. They're interesting. I'll give you two that we read this morning. One said, "Now is a good time to visit our church. Our pastor is on vacation." And then this from the Baptist church: "What happens in Vegas is all forgiven here." And gives the name of the pastor. That's most interesting, isn't it?
Yes.
To say the least. Today or tomorrow is Memorial Day, a day that we set aside to remember those brave men and women who served our country. It is a day that I call a day of remembrance. That's the title of our message today. I always like, because it's the teacher in me, to bring instruction and information together with inspiration in the messages. Now, when was Memorial Day officially declared or proclaimed? May 5th, 1868, General John Logan, National Commander of the Grand Army of the Republic. The first state to officially recognize the holiday was New York in 1873. By 1890, the entire country, by declaration within Washington that Memorial Day should be a federal holiday. And so on this day, we pause and thank God for those men and women who served our armed forces. Amen. We owe a debt to each and every one of them. It is, as far as I'm concerned, a holy day of remembrance. And if you will just remember that in this message today, we can again substantiate that by some of the things that we find in the Word of God. What do you think of when you think of Memorial Day? The unofficial start of summer? Well, we're going to wait, I think, for summer to officially start, because it's not been very nice, has it? But that's okay, right? There's a purpose in that. We think of family get-togethers. Would you believe that in most churches, Memorial Day is ignored? Because it's not one of the holy days. You know, it's not Easter or Good Friday or any one of the holy days. But it is very important, because we have been given the opportunity to remember. Memory is a great gift. You, as well as myself, are acquainted with individuals who at this particular time in their life are having debilitating circumstances with regard to remembering. That can be most difficult for all concerned. It's a blessing to be able to remember, to have the ability to recall some wonderful experiences, some of the experiences that bring you joy, some of the experiences that will bring you sorrow. If we couldn't remember that a red light means stop, we'd really be in big trouble, wouldn't we? If you wouldn't be able to remember what day it is, or your anniversary, or your wife's birthday, you'd be in big, big, big trouble, wouldn't you? You certainly would. The problem, though, is that sometimes memory fails us, and sometimes we definitely do forget. There are some events that we should never forget. And Memorial Day commemorates some of them. Tomorrow is set aside to remember those who lost their lives serving our country in battle. I did a little bit of research in preparation for this message today. In all of the wars in which the United States has been involved, there have been 1,343,000 men and women that have lost their lives. 1,343,000. Total wounded in all wars, 1,529,230 that have been wounded. We are looking at a total of 3 million individuals. 3 million individuals who have either in that group lost their lives or again have been wounded in battle. There are over 136 in the United States military cemeteries around the world. These are memorials. One of the greatest experiences that I had was when we, as a choral group, Philadelphia Boys Choir and Chorale, about 5 years ago, had the opportunity when we visited Normandy and we sang at the cemetery. And I will never, ever forget that experience as we stood there at the cemetery with all of the tombstones before us. And we thought and we looked out as men and boys as we sang patriotic songs. And we thought the lives were lost because of the invasion of which we certainly know happened there. So we as people, see, need to remember that monuments and memorials are important for us. So important that we have a memorial in Scripture. The time had come that Israel was going to enter the promised land. And after their many years of wandering, all because of their fault, they are ready to now go over. Now they're camped just across the Jordan River from Jericho. You heard the scripture. The priests were carrying the Ark of the Covenant, and they had to go ahead. People were to stay back 3,000 feet. Let me tell you something about the climate and the situation. They were crossing the Jordan at harvest time. Now, the Jordan River floods at harvest time, which means it just doubles, triples in size. And when the priests, remember the whole nation had to cross over. When the priest entered the Jordan, in order for them to cross. It was almost a replication of what God did for his people at the Red Sea. Remember that? See? So when the priests entered the Jordan, and there was this great upstream, surely that the people would have lost their lives and they would have drowned. The priests stood in the middle of the Jordan until the entire nation had crossed over. And you heard the scripture. Joshua said to the Israelites, in the future, when your descendants ask their parents, what do these stones mean? Tell them, Israel crossed the Jordan on dry ground, for the Lord God dried up the Jordan before you until you crossed over. The command was that when they were to do this, Joshua told one man from each of the 12 tribes, he said, go into the riverbed and select 12 large stones. And they brought the stones. And they brought them to the river's edge, to the bank, and they made a monument out of them. Just envision 12 stones and a monument. And Joshua says, in the future, when your children ask, what do these stones mean? Tell them that the flow of the Jordan was cut off before the Ark of the Covenant. And when it crossed the Jordan, the waters of the Jordan were cut off. And here's what I want you to remember. These stones are to be a memorial. These stones, so when the generations and the children afterward, what does this mean here? What do these stones represent? They're to be a memorial to the people of Israel forever. We are the most blessed nation on the face of the earth. Do you believe that?
Amen.
We are the most blessed nation on the face of the earth. And sometimes we take these blessings, especially the blessing of freedom, for granted. We take them for granted. There's a motto that the military live by. Give me liberty, or give me death. And that has been the motto of every American man or woman that has fought in all of the wars. If you were to go to Arlington Cemetery today, in Arlington National Cemetery, there's a tomb, the tomb of the unknown soldier. And upon that sacred tomb are engraved these words: here rests in honor and glory an American soldier known but to God. The willingness of our nation to sacrifice families, sacrifice sons, daughters, sacrifice their possessions, sacrifice everything so that we could be a free people, so that we know the true meaning of freedom. And let me declare today, and I wish there were ways in which which this could be heard by so many who just don't share these values. And I want to say this, freedom is a privilege, not a right. Freedom is a privilege, not a right. Freedom has never been free. Individuals have made great sacrifices. Individuals that we honor today have paid the supreme sacrifice, and we honor them, and we again respect the sacrifice of those that have made the supreme sacrifice.
Amen.
We do not have the freedom to do what is not right in this land. We do not have the freedom to live here and defame our country.
Amen.
One of the things that gets my Italian up.
Amen.
And that is when I see our wonderful athletes making millions of dollars, given the opportunity that only we have given, and they kneel, excuse me for getting excited, and they kneel in disdain against everything that we as Americans hold sacred. Instead of standing and honoring the flag of the United States of America, we stand for the flag, we kneel at the cross. Amen, church.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen. Hallelujah.
And yet, on the other hand, unfortunately, that is being taught by politicians who hate America. And if you hate our country, just go back to where you came from. We have given you the opportunity to advance and to exist in a free country that ultimate sacrifices have been made, that mothers have given, sons, wives have given, husbands, etc. Do you know what? This will bring back some memories. That oath of every military individual takes when they're ready to be inducted into the military. Let me just read it for you. It'll bring back some memories to some of you that said this. I, and you put your name, do solemnly swear that I will support, defend the Constitution of the United States against all enemies, foreign and domestic, that I will bear true faith and allegiance to the same, and that I will obey the orders of the President of the United States and the orders of the officers appointed over me according to the regulations and the Uniform Code of Military Justice. So help me God.
Amen.
Our text this morning and our scripture tells of another who gave and made such an oath. And that individual was none other than our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. as men and women sacrificed for our physical freedom, He sacrificed for our spiritual freedom. He made the supreme sacrifice. Because in the Gospel of John, it says, "For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him should not perish, but have everlasting life." Now, what is the memorial that the Lord has put into place today? And that is this: just as the 12 stones were to be a memorial for future generations, and let me share this to make it personal, church. We, the church, we are the memorials in this day and age, because Paul wrote to the church of Corinth, "Don't you know," and that "you" is "don't you all know," "that all of you yourselves are God's temple, and that God's Spirit lives in you, and God's Spirit lives in us as a body of Christ, as a memorial to our Lord." And so, every one of us today, we are a living memorial for the Lord. And as a Christian, I am supposed to be that memorial, that there is a Savior, and His name is Jesus, and He came into the world to die for all sinners that are lost, amen, and can receive eternal life. See, how can we do this? We do this by being people of character, passionate with our love for the Lord Jesus Christ. And it must be done through the power of the Holy Spirit. And when we are living a life that is righteous in the sight of God, we are being that living memorial that He is looking for. We are the memorials. Let me ask you a question. When people come to Berlin Baptist Church, what do you want them to leave with? Do you want them to come simply to admire our beautiful building? And it is beautiful, amen?
Amen.
Yes, it is. See? But do you want them to come and to feel the presence of the Holy Spirit, amen? And to be lifted up and to be fed? And do you want that individuals that are discouraged leave with encouragement, and that individuals that do not find peace can find peace? That's what we are all about. We are a local body, a church. We are memorials unto the Lord. Amen. And that is our goal and our objective. See? And so this Memorial Day, let us rethink. Tomorrow we will remember those that died that we might live free. But today I want you to remember the fact that an innocent man, he died so that each and every one of us could be free from the bondage of sin. Amen.
Amen.
And that we could enjoy and have eternal life. He died that we might live eternally in that place called heaven. And if you appreciate that, can you say amen today?
Amen.
Father, thank you. Make us a living memorial. I thank you for being the example. And Lord, today we thank you for every military person in our church, in our family, those that are here with us, those that paid the supreme sacrifice. Thank you for answering mothers' prayers when they saw their children to go off into battle. Thank you that they returned safely, but there were so many in that number that we gave today that did not return. We think of wounded warriors today. We think of so many that are still in the heat of the battle, oh God. And we pray for our country. We pray for those men and women who would dare to desecrate, who would dare to defame our freedoms bought with a precious price. Help us, especially tomorrow, to pause and simply say, thank you, Lord. Thank you. He whom the Son sets free is free indeed. Hallelujah.
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 And we thank you that we are a free people. And to you, the only wise God, be all glory and honor and praise. In your holy name we pray. Amen. Take your hymnal, let's stand and sing. Verses 1 and 3, mine eyes have seen the glory coming of the Lord. Thank you again thank you again for those that we do remember with extreme gratitude. Love, joy, peace, communion that only comes from God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, go with us until we shall meet again. Amen.
Amen.
Oh, you're kidding! Her system is right near us. Her system.